So you need to send a JPEG to a client as a reference, or maybe you just need to grab a frame for your YouTube thumbnail. It's not apparent in DaVinci Resolve, but it is as simple as right-clicking in the color page to grab a still, and then right-clicking to export that JPEG from the stills gallery. But do you want to understand how to see your hidden stills folder with a keyboard shortcut on a Mac? Or maybe learn a slick new trick to reverse the match frame from your stills down to your timeline? Then stick around for another minute to go a little deeper. Welcome if you're new here. I'm Chadwick. This is Creative Video Tips, where I help you craft stories that make a difference and stand out. I teach a lot of video editing techniques in DaVinci Resolve, so if you're into that, subscribe so you don't miss out on next week's tip. The first thing you want to do before creating your still is to open your project settings with the little gear icon in the lower right. Check your master settings, timeline settings. Make your timeline resolution match the source clip resolution to maintain the highest quality. Sometimes you want to edit at 1920 by 1080 HD resolution for faster, smoother playback, but then export at 3840 by 2160 to retain the 4K quality that was shot. Just make sure to flip this back to 3840 by 2160 to get a full UHD still pulled. While you're in master settings, scroll down to working folders for the project and you'll see where DaVinci Resolve stores the gallery stills. Mine are set to the documents folder on my Mac, and if you click browse, it takes you right to that folder. DaVinci Resolve saves the stills as DPX files, but you won't see them if you try to find this folder from the Finder. That's because it's hidden. To unhide that folder on a Mac, type Command Shift Period. And now you can see the hidden folders. It's like a magic trick. If you hit it again, it disappears. That's Command Shift Period. I don't dive in there often, but it's essential to understand where Resolve saves them. Oh, and Photoshop can open these DPX files too. By default, the Stills Gallery will be your first location in your Resolve system preferences for media storage. Now to pull a still frame, go to the color page. I like to open up the clip's timeline in the upper right, and then also open up the gallery panel in the upper left. Click the clip that you want to pull a still from and move the playhead to a moment that doesn't have a lot of unwanted motion blur, which is an effect of filming with a 180-degree shutter speed. Right-click on the viewer itself and grab the still. Resolve sends that frame to the stills gallery, which includes the image and the node structure, so if you did any color corrections to it, you can see and display the node graph by right-clicking, which is helpful if you want to copy and paste adjustments to other clips, but in our case today, click export, name it something logical, and pick a safe location on your computer and change the format down below to JPEG. Oh, and if you need a lot of stills quickly, you can also grab all the clips first and middle frames with a single click and then batch export them. And a sweet quick bonus tip that I learned from Darren Mostyn, who has an incredible YouTube channel on DaVinci Resolve from a colorist perspective, is that you can use the still to match back down to the timeline. This is similar to performing a reverse match frame for my editor friends out there. Just right click on the still and choose match reference wipe frame. This one's been super cool and new to me in the past year. And if you're new to DaVinci Resolve, I have a playlist popping up on screen right now that covers so many of the pitfalls that editors come across when first learning this super powerful software. And since there is so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.